So, molecular cytogenetics is a bit different. In the conventional methodology, we were using the chromosomes and we were analyzing them in light microscopes. Now we are with the fluorescent in situ hybridization station. In this technique, the FISH technique needs DNA probes that hybridizes to specific chromosomal regions, and then with fluorescein microscopes we visualize the probes and analyze specific regions of the chromosomes. Talk about the workflow of the FISH technique. We will, as we said before, need fluorescein probes that will hybridize to specific chromosomal regions. We are working in relatively dark area because the intensity and the brightness of the probe will be lost otherwise. The DNA, as we know, has two chains, and if we denaturate the DNA, then it will be easy for us to hybridize the probe. For this we will need an incubation. First of all, the denaturation step will take place in high temperatures, and then the incubation will take place at 37 degrees. After the hybridization takes place overnight, the other day we are washing the slides and then counter staining. We are using a counter stain called DEPI. The DEPI and now we are ready to visualize. Okay, now we are now analyzing the FISH chromosomes. As you see, it's a bit different from the conventional technique. We are seeing the counter stain DEPI in blue and the probes in red and green. As you see, one of them is the control probe and one of them is the test probe. We have a diploid set of chromosomes in humans. So we are in this normal cell seeing both the test and control probes in two identical chromosomes. So now let's talk about another molecular cytogenetic technology that again uses hybridization procedure. Now this time this is called molecular karyotyping. As you see, the chromosome ideograms are here ready, and we are again using DNA test samples, and we are using chip technology. The DNA of our patient will hybridize to the chip, and inside the chip there is a SNP map of all the human genome, or in CGH technology, which is the comparative genomic hybridization, there is a reference male or female normal chromosome sample. The test sample hybridizes to the chip, and the gains and the lost parts of the chromosomal regions can be analyzed by using specific softwares. For example, in this patient, as you see, there is a loss in chromosome X and there is a partial gain in Y chromosome of the patient. As we said, DNA technology is part of molecular cytogenetic technique, but a bit more molecular. We are using these thermal cyclers to incubate our DNA-based samples. For example, for the workflow of the DNA technology, we are cutting the DNA regularly in equal parts. We call the specified technique, for example, for this nick translation. Of course, there are some other techniques to make this. And we bind our malted DNA probes, and then we will hybridize to the chip. This is our chip. We put our test sample into it, and we will let our sample to hybridize to the chip, and we will wait for the hybridization process. So after the hybridization process, we will need to wash the chips, and then after the washing process, we will scan them with specialized scanners. And after the scanning process, as we saw before, we will analyze the chip using specified softwares.